everybody, today I would like to present the academic paper and efficient approach for the short-term forecasting using artificial neural network. The outline for today, I present the first one. I will show you the introduction of the load forecasting, and the next I will show you the motivation and the problem statement. The next one I will show you the methodology for the short-term load forecasting by the ANN method, and the last one I will show you the result and the conclusion. Okay, let me start the first one. In this slide, you can see the figure that the load demand is increased over the year from the 2000 until the 2040 in every sector such as the transportation, residential, commercial, or the factory, and the utility and service provider must to manage the energy to meet the customer requirement. The one efficient tool for manage energy is the load forecast tool. There are two methods for the load forecast tool. The first one is the statistical method, such as the hydrocubic method, and the next one is the machine learning method, such as the artificial neural network. Okay, the objective of this paper is to one, short-term load forecasting by using the artificial neural network with the vector variable to be the ANN input, and compare the performance between the ANN method and the hydrocubic method. Okay, problem statement. The problem for the load forecasting is the how to predict the load profile, why in the accuracy how to predict the load profile in the hydrocubic system is difficult because the one electricity load demand is vary over the time, and the load pattern is not same for the each time, and the in previous the author proposed the ANN for load forecast by using the historical data load and the vector variable, the wind speed, the cloud cover, and the temperature to be the ANN input. And the problem is the load data is not available for the short-term load forecast. Ahead for the 2 or 3 days is not available, so the author must use the estimate load data to be the ANN input, and this is give the error to the model. Okay, in the previous work, the input for ANN is the day indicator, how indicator, temperature, cloud cover, and the wind velocity. For this work, the input is the day indicator, how indicator, and the temperature. Okay, methodology for the load forecasting. Step 1, variable selection for the ANN input. Use the correlation matrix to select the variable that significant to the load system. Y, determine about load and the temperature, load and wind speed, and load and cloud cover. You will see that the value of the correlation between load and temperature is high value. So the author choose the temperature variable to be the vector variable input of the ANN. The step 2, the ANN model for the short-term load forecasting in the gray box. You can see this is the artificial neural network for this forecasting. Why have the input is the how indicator, the indicator, temperature, like at the step K-2, K-1, and at the step time K. And the output of this model is the load at time K. Why the data for training and the validation model, the author used the variable from the hydrocubic area in year 1994. And this graph showed the result for the short-term load forecasting while using the validation set. In the graph, you can see that the red graph is the result of the error for model. The index for estimate the model, we use the root mean square error or the RMSE. And the blue graph is the result of the RMSE from the hydrocubic method. You can see that this red graph is give the high RMSE more than the ANN method. It can conclude that ANN method give the good performance for the short-term load forecasting in the hydrocubic area more than the hydrocubic method, and the other variables such as the cloud cover and wind velocity is not significant effect to the load system. For the better result, it must depend on the type of N and N, the how to choose the variable to be the input, and the training data set for N and N. Thank you.
The question
is why, how to choose the data set for training NNN? How many data? The author choose the data period from the month 1 until the month 12 or the 1 year of the data in the 1994. The data is come from the hydrocubic system area. And it can separate the data into two sets. The first set is the training set that used to estimate and building the NNN model. And the last set is the validation set that used to validate or estimate the performance of the NNN.
Short term load forecasting. The short term is mean how short is that?
What does it mean? That say the short term load forecasting. The short term load forecasting is long. How long?
I just wonder that why it's called the short term load forecasting.
Okay, the load forecasting can be classified into the three periods. The first is the short term, it means that forecast ahead for the about the 30 minutes, 1 hour until the 1 day or the 2 day, not over the 1 week. And the medium term load forecasting is forecast over the month to the 3 months, and the long term load forecasting is forecast over 3 months until the many years ahead. And in this paper, we say the short term load forecasting because we forecast ahead about the 2 until 3 years ahead. Today ahead.
Why do you include cloud cover and wind speed in the ANN? Why these variables relate to, you know, the load
profile? The variable such as the weather variable, the cloud cover and wind velocity is the variable input in the previous work of this author.
Yeah. Why you decide to remove these two variables?
In my opinion, I think the wind velocity and the cloud cover, I think it's not significantly related to the load demand, but significantly related to the about the solar or the RE generation. And I think the load is not, because when plot the correlation, but I not show in this presentation. And you can see that the relate between this variable is not related to the load system.